It says here, you know, that we'll have another opportunity if anyone wants to say something, just holler. The message that that I want to share, and Bill brought up, I mean, we know that Leon accepted Jesus Christ as his Savior. So we're comforted that he's in heaven. That's something that we can all experience and take comfort in, that we share with our brothers and sisters here. And, you know, to feel the love and to have the inner love that exudes like Leon's did. I mean, shoot, to see him smile and just greet you, like Bill said, totally incredible. Incredible. And so I don't have much. I'm going to offer a few verses. Psalm 23, which is very well known by most, if not all. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And that's a reminder when we went up and saw Leon in the hospital, and he talked about some new drug they had that really wasn't chemo, so it might not be so bad. And he said, you know, if it works, okay. If it doesn't work, okay. So, you know, he was good with it. So I think that that assurance and that belief are just incredible. So that's something that I'm sure he would want for all of us, just to have that confidence that it's okay. We're all good. He's happy. He's with the Lord and sharing all that. The second verse that I have is Romans 8:35 and 37-39. It's, who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? No. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And it's just something that we can all take to heart, that I think Leon lived and embodied, that he wasn't afraid of anything. Is knowing Jesus Christ was a big part of that. So, we're going to have another song in just a moment, and then we'll have our closing. Something I just want to put forth to all of you guys and girls, from witnessing Leon's life and, you know, his assuredness with Christ, is if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life, you can. If you do have, bless you. But there's a verse in the Bible, and it's Romans 10:9, and it says, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And with that assurance and that belief, we join those of our loved ones that have, you know, preceded us and gone on to heaven. And we join them and celebrate. And we are celebrating Leon today. So grateful for all of you. And we'll play another song. And Charlotte will cue that. We're good. Thank you. While listening to that, two things came to me. One was that the grace, you know, I mentioned the invitation to accept Jesus Christ in your life. That doesn't mean living a perfect life. That's what grace is for, you know. So I think the ones that feel like they have to be perfect might be religious. The ones that know God loves them regardless might be relational. The second thing was the baby sound, you know. Right on the finger. That's just the indication of life, you know, and the beauty and the purity and what we all have to work for is the enjoyment of life and seeing younger ones grow and shaped and turning out like those of us that pass on. But you know, those two things came, so I want everyone here to just know that. Being saved is not being perfect. Being saved is loving God and trusting Him as your Savior. And the beauty of this model kid was on the cues. If anybody else has anything they want to say, please. I mean, gosh, what a wonderful thing.
So what a blessing to watch the smile on Uncle Leon's face and know he loves you kids, man. That's awesome. And loved his cars. I remember growing up, we spent a lot of time over there with him. And not a lot, but it seemed like it was a lot back then. But I loved to go over there and see the Mustangs and hang out with him, working on the cars and all the things he did. And there's one thing you could always put a smile on his face. Is begin talking about cars or talking about jets. And it was always fun to watch him talk about that. But just wanted to share what a blessing it was to see. You get this point, you don't get to hang out with people like that for 25 years, and then you get to come back together and see the friends, and you see the family, and you see the smiles, and you know that he was a loving man. And kind of missed out on that for 25 years, and time flies. But above all that, I'm just so thankful to hear Stephen say that he accepted Christ as his Savior. I had a real tough time last month when I found out that he was had cancer. And that was one of my concerns was, did he know Christ was his Savior? Don't let another day go by. I know without a doubt that he was going to share that. If there's anything that he could share, the jets, the cars, the family, all of that is wonderful. But if you don't know Christ, it's all for naught. So family, just know that he loved you. That's amazing. I love the story. I love the pictures. And it was good to see the smile on his face. Thank you.
Anybody else have something they want to say? And thank you all for sharing.
It feels a little strange to be here today in front of you all. Most of you don't know me. I have the great fortune of working for Shelley. And I've met Leon once. One time. But what I wanted to share with you is what I know about Leon through the love he has for Shelley and all of his friends. I heard about it constantly. Sorry. And if it's possible to know someone because of the love they have for their family and friends, then I'm blessed to have known Leon for many years. And I will carry that with me as long as I'm around. So, thank you.
I wish I could interpret what she's saying. It's good. Anybody else have something they want to share? I mean, what an awesome celebration of a fantastic meal.
Morgan's Mustangs and his son's Mustangs and Shelly's Mustang, and helped him tune them over the years. And Leon just was really loving. He was like a second dad to me. I don't know, maybe 6 years ago or so, I was working on the old Cadillac, and he was giving me fits, and he came over there one day, and he showed me how to set points, and I was like, well, you know, growing up in the fuel injection age, I never was around points, much less carburetors. He helped me get that thing tuned up and running, and he's a good man all in all. I loved him. He came and saw me like almost every week, and just going to miss that about him. Just happy to know that he's in heaven, and he's pain-free, and his suffering is short. And condolences to the family, and I love y'all, and if you need any help, let me know. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh. Anybody else have anything they want to say? We'll close now, and then we'll have a pass by, and we'll let the family go first, and then we'll all be able to come and live in one more time and forever in our heart. I'm going to say a prayer, and if you have any questions or want to comment afterwards, please let it loose, because this is our time. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for your presence here today. We are thankful for all that you have given us. Lord, we are thankful. Lord, we are especially thankful for the life of Leon and the imprints that it has left on our hearts, in our minds, and on our lives. Lord, we just pray that you would continue to comfort, console, lend understanding to the family, to all of us, Lord, because we're all family for a man like that. Lord, we ask that you would put a path before us that we walk that would be honoring unto you, Lord, that would reflect Leon's love, and just one that we will always remember the smile on his face. Lord, we are so grateful for the precious gift you gave us of Jesus Christ. And it's in his name we pray. And I just had a thought. It was that Leon's account of how happy he was when he met Shelly.
I'm just mad. Oh, I think I got to get a little bit of her face. She's going to cry a while.
That was good. I thought it was
I'm going to go to the Are you well enough that I can hug you?